Good morning and happy World Environment Day to one and all present here. We have with us our beloved principal who is a guiding force behind this program. Our chief guest, Dr. Veena Nagaraj, who is an economist, environmentalist and Rotarian professor of MES College. On this World Environment Day, biodiversity as a theme, protecting and conserving our biodiversity for the good, conducive and habitual environment. It is our responsibility to understand that every species on earth has an intrinsic value and we have moral duty to care for their well-being and pass it on our biological legacy to the next future generation. Let us all join hands in keeping our environment in good and healthy condition. Let us stay healthy in this environment and also together fighting the pandemic, that is Corona. All of us, let us stay at home and safe and healthy staying. Thank you.
Warm wishes to all of you. Respected Principal Professor T. Dodde Gowda, staff, students and all the members of NGC Eco Club of Seshadripuram PU College, Yelahanka. 5th June is celebrated as the World Environment Day. Every year, there are celebrations on a very specific theme, and this year, the theme is Time for Nature. In fact, these kinds of celebrations began as early as 1972. Now it has grown to be a very global activity, you know, an important action initiated by the United Nations. Ideally, it engages millions across the globe, involving both the young and the old. Environment is not yours, not mine, but it's ours. So it's our joint responsibility to nourish it. Make it a habit to spend more time with nature. It may help in reducing anxiety, fear, stress, strain, tension. It boosts pleasant feelings. It's emotionally a very satisfying experience to be around nature. It reduces blood pressure, pumps in good, you know, blood and makes a person very healthy. The stress hormones are controlled when you are around nature. What we see, hear and experience around us not only impacts our mind, but it also influences our endocrine and immune systems. So an unpleasant environment around us makes us sad, anxious, helpless, tense, and this elevates the BP, heart rate, muscle tension. It may suppress the immune system, but a pleasant environment can reverse all this. Nature helps us to cope with pain. Robert G. Ulrich, a former United States Army Medical Research Institute, you know, researcher, he conducted a small research. It's a very classical study and a very classical example given to highlight the significance of nature. You know what he did? He took a batch of, a number of people who underwent gallbladder surgery. He made arrangements where half of the patients had a view of the green lustrous trees and another half had the view of a wall when they were recovering in the rooms after the surgery. Now it was recorded, medically recorded, that people who had the view of trees tolerated pain better, had less negative effects, and they spent less time in the hospital as they recovered very fast with the help of nature. So most people say that they feel, that their mood improves and, they are happy when they spend their time in the parks. People feel that they become calm, composed and balanced after spending time with nature. Now, what can youngsters like you do? You can visit a park, a green area around your house. In fact, I suggest all of you to make a map of the green areas around your, your extension so that, you keep a track of what are the various covers, green covers around you. And then youngsters can also build a birdhouse. It's a pleasant experience to build a house, put it in, on your perch or on your sit-outs. and watch birds coming in, enjoying a little water or the small, small grains that you put over there, and then see how they react to human beings. I request all of you to pay attention to the rare and beautiful flowers and plants that are around in your area or the parks that you visit. In fact, it would be wonderful if you can do some gardening, you know, on your own. It's a great mental feeling to see how plants grow when you nurture them every day, when you water them every day. You start spending less time with your gadgets and then spend more time with your, you know, plants. Just observe that small change that takes place in you when you understand this kind of a beauty that you find in nature. Why should we preserve nature? Now, all around us, there is the shortage of water, food, and there's a lot of pollution that we talk about. So, a healthy environment provides nutrients that follow up the world food chain, and then from plants to the animals, and to provide energy. A clean supply of air and water is the best medicine for human beings to thrive. So, I list the following benefits of spending time with nature, which is the theme of this year's Environmental Day. The physical benefits are taken care of when you do bicycle rides, kayaking, hiking, climbing. Your physique improves, your mood improves, there's that lift which makes you a very happy person. Now, the mental health benefits are a clear mind, a happy mind, and then, you know, when you are happy, people around you find you very easy to deal with, and then you as a happy student, happy person will be an asset to the society. The third benefit is the social benefit. It can help us in problem solving, team building, and such other exercises which are very much essential for being the good citizen of a country. The fourth benefit that I list out is the productivity benefit. Motivation, good energy to work when you are amidst nature. That itself can bring in more manners and productive nature to the society. The last one, of course, is the environmental benefit. Now, a green environment is the best gift that we can pass on to the others, that we can enjoy today, and then take care to see that it goes, it is passed on to the next generation as well. So spend a little more time with nature this year, and you know, nature, when it is nurtured, becomes a national asset. So I sincerely request all of you to pay attention to the nature around you, and then, you know, be nature conscious. This will certainly help you in, you know, helping the world and giving a better nature to the next generation as well. I thank Professor Jayashree for giving me this opportunity to speak to all of you. Thank you. Have a good day.
Namaskara. ನಾನು ವೆಂಕಟರೆಡ್ಡಿ ರಾಮರೆಡ್ಡಿ, ಕನ್ನಡ ಪ್ರಾಧ್ಯಾಪಕ, ತುಮಕೂರು ವಿಶ್ವವಿದ್ಯಾನಿಲಯ, ತುಮಕೂರು. ನಾಳೆ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿನ ಯಲಹಂಕದ ಶೇಷಾದ್ರಿಪುರಂ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನವರು ವಿಶ್ವ ಪರಿಸರ ದಿನಾಚರಣೆಯನ್ನು ಆಚರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ಸಂತಸವನ್ನು ತಂದಿದೆ. ಕೊರೋನಾ ಕಾಯಿಲೆಯ ದುರಾಕ್ರಮಣದ ಸಮಕಾಲೀನ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ವೈಯಕ್ತಿಕ ಸ್ವಚ್ಛತೆಯೊಂದಿಗೆ ಸಾಮುದಾಯಿಕ ಸ್ವಚ್ಛತೆಯು ಕೂಡ ಬಹಳ ಮಹತ್ವವನ್ನು ಪಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತೆ. ಇಂಥ ವೈಯಕ್ತಿಕ ಮತ್ತು ಸಾಮುದಾಯಿಕ ಸ್ವಚ್ಛತೆಯನ್ನು ಕುರಿತು ಅರಿವನ್ನು ಮೂಡಿಸುತ್ತಿರುವ ವಿಶ್ವ ಪರಿಸರ ದಿನಾಚರಣೆಯನ್ನು ಆಚರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇರುವ ಶೇಷಾದ್ರಿಪುರಂ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಜಯಶ್ರೀ ಎಂ ಒಡೆಯರವರಿಗೂ, ಕಾಲೇಜಿನ ಪ್ರಾಂಶುಪಾಲರವರಿಗೂ, ಅದೇ ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿ ಆಡಳಿತ ಮಂಡಳಿಯವರಿಗೂ ಈ ಮೂಲಕ ಹೃತ್ಪೂರ್ವಕವಾದ ವಂದನೆಗಳನ್ನು ಸಲ್ಲಿಸುತ್ತೇನೆ.
ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ಹಾಗೂ ವಿಶ್ವ ಪರಿಸರ ದಿನಾಚರಣೆಯ ಹಾರ್ದಿಕ ಶುಭಾಶಯಗಳು. ಇಂದು ಶೇಷಾದ್ರಿಪುರಂ ಕಾಲೇಜು ಯಲಹಂಕ ಉಪನಗರದ ಈ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಕೊರೋನಾ ವೈರಸ್ನ ಈ ಜಾಗತಿಕ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆಗಳ ಮಧ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಮಾಜವನ್ನು ಸುಭಿಕ್ಷವಾಗಿಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ, ಇಡೀ ಸಮಾಜವನ್ನು ಪರಿಸರಾತ್ಮಕವಾಗಿ ಶುಚಿತ್ವದ ಕಡೆಗೆ ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗುವಂತಹ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನದಲ್ಲಿ ವಿಶ್ವ ಪರಿಸರ ದಿನಾಚರಣೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈ ಆಯೋಜನೆ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಆಡಳಿತ ಮಂಡಳಿ, ಪ್ರಾಂಶುಪಾಲರು ಮತ್ತು ಇದರ ಪದಾಧಿಕಾರಿಗಳೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ನಾನು ಹೃತ್ಪೂರ್ವಕವಾದ ಅಭಿನಂದನೆಗಳನ್ನ ಸಲ್ಲಿಸ್ತೀನಿ. ನಾನು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಶೀಲಾದೇವಿ ಎಸ್ ಮಳಿಮಠ ವಿಎಂಎಸ್ ಮಹಿಳಾ ಕಾಲೇಜು ಸಹ ಪ್ರಾಧ್ಯಾಪಕಿ. ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಶುಭವಾಗಲಿ. ಅತ್ಯುತ್ತಮವಾದಂತಹ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ. ನೀವು ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೇ ಇರಿ, ಸುರಕ್ಷಿತವಾಗಿರಿ, ಕೊರೋನಾವನ್ನ ಓಡಿಸಿ. ನಿಮಗೆಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಪರಿಸರ ದಿನಾಚರಣೆಯ ಹಾರ್ದಿಕ ಶುಭಾಶಯಗಳು.
Hello everyone, I'm Ruma and an active environmentalist working with Manav Charities, an NGO based out of Bangalore, which works for education, socio-economic development, empowerment, environment, to name a few. Manav Charities is actively involved in various programs like Go Green clubs in schools, plantation of trees, collection of used cartridges for recycling, awareness and workshops. It gives me an immense pleasure in addressing the students of Seshadripuram PUC College, Yelahanka, respected Principal Professor T. Doddegowda, for being kind enough to host this program under NGC Eco Club. Also, my heartfelt thanks to Professor Jayashree Vodaya for giving me an opportunity to address Seshadripuram College staff and students. I am here to talk a few words and share my views on environment. As we celebrate the World Environment Day, amid the COVID-19 pandemic, where we are facing health crisis which has created a havoc across the globe, in a matter of months the world has been transformed. Thousands of people are already dying, hundreds of them have fallen ill. I urge you all to stay safe and protect our environment, which is one of the most important aspects to survive on this planet. Today, the world is experiencing considerable social changes and facing new challenges. As we are aware that the environment means the surroundings made of five elements, namely air, water, land, sky and fire, for us to flourish. We should be very grateful towards the earth and that we have been provided with such a great environment that has everything in the nature which helps us to live. But day by day, we are ruining it on the highest pitch that will eventually lead us towards our destruction. So it is absolutely important for us to protect our environment. Our environment provides us with a lot of things, but what are we giving in return? Nothing but disturbances. We disturb the whole Mother Nature. Our disturbances not only affect the life of trees and other resources, but also affects our life. Have you ever thought what we are doing? After eating chips and chocolates, we throw the wrappers on the road. After drinking juice, we throw the cans on the road. All these waste we throw makes it look dirty, first of all, and also these heaps and waste what is collected gives way for the insects and other various diseases. On the other hand, plastics take at least 450 years to decompose with the soil, and even after decomposing, the soil won't be suitable for growing crops in future. We all know that global warming, which is one of the root causes which ruins the environment, is because of us. Therefore, we have to unite together to take some steps to reduce global warming, pollution and all the other things which ruins our environment. Out of this, the question arises is that what kind of future we want, or what kind of future we are going to hand over to the next generation? Is this kind of development we are dreaming about? Walking with a mask on the face, struggling with the floods, earthquakes, destruction of animals who aren't even aware of what's happening around. Each and every day there is a new problem arising, and now it is high time where we need to recognize the importance of our nature and our natural environments and try every possible action in saving it from destruction. Good or bad quality of social life depends on our quality and quality of our natural environment. The need of human beings for food, water, shelter and other things depends on the environment around us. There is a balanced natural cycle exists between environment and the lives of human beings, plants, animals. Human society is playing a vital role in degenerating the natural environment, which in turn negatively affects the life of this planet. All the human actions in this modern world directly impacts the whole ecosystem. Our healthy and natural environment is getting worse day by day, and taking this form of demon is affecting everything from non-living to living beings. we must understand the importance of ecological balance and try our best to run it naturally in order to prevent the effects of environmental disasters and promote the existence of healthy environment. We should promote common public in our surroundings for clean and green environment to prove the meaning of proverb what we call we won't have a society if we destroy the environment. So we should realize our mistakes and concerns and have some concern about the environment in order to keep it clean, safe and secure for a healthy life. Many of the human activities like deforestation, industrialization, pollution and technological improvements are leading our environment to the worlds of danger, keeping lives at risk by influencing the growth, development and survival of all organisms. Let's take oath to strive and make sustainable use of our natural environment so that no species will be threatened or disappear because of our actions. And we strive here to protect all species, particularly those that are rare, threatened and endangered. So here I'm wishing you all a very happy Environment Day. Thank you.